Coalition of Labor Leaders backs Vice President Lenny Robredo's presidential bid for 2022. All for Lenny, or the Alliance of Labor Leaders for Lenny, believes Robredo will help them push for workers' rights, citing her track record. The group vows to deliver at least 2 million voters for the vice president on election day. It also hopes one of their members, Sonny Matula, will be included in Robredo's senatorial slate.
And mataas pa diyan kung susumahin. The membership of the All for Lenny includes about 350,000 workers, yung existing. But we are still expanding. We are recruiting other organizations in overseas. Tapos marami pa tayong mga organization na sa informal sector na hindi pa natin naisari dito sa ating computation.
Presidential aspirant and Senator Manny Pacquiao will continue to give cash aid to Filipinos in need in the run-up to the 2022 elections. Pacquiao earlier drew flak after several videos showed he handed out cash to those who attended his political sortie in Batangas last week. Pacquiao's camp denies insinuations of vote buying, saying he was doing it out of charity.
Sabi nga niya, hindi naman siya titigil tutulong sa tao dahil ayaw ng ibang tao or binibigyan ng kulay. So wala pong violation dyan. Yan ang sabi niya. Attorney, hindi ako titigil gumawa ng kabutihan. Nangangailangan yung mga tao natin, nagugutom, nasalantat. At kung meron man silang gustong bigyan ng kulay, sila na po yun. Basta tayo po sa team po ni Senator Manny ay tumutulong po tayo sa tao.
In business, the International Monetary Fund cuts its 2021 growth forecast for Asia. It now sees the region growing 6.5%, down from its earlier estimate of 7.6%. But it raised its outlook for next year, citing progress on the COVID-19 vaccination front. The IMF warns a fresh wave of COVID infections, supply chain disruptions, and inflation pressures continue to pose downside risks to its outlook. It says the divergence between advanced and emerging economies in Asia is deepening, with Indonesia, Malaysia, the Philippines, Singapore, and Thailand still facing severe challenges. It adds any untimely policy normalization by the U.S. Federal Reserve could also trigger significant capital outflow and higher borrowing costs for emerging Asian economies.
Philippine Energy Secretary Alfonso Pusi and Udena boss Dennis Uy faced a graft complaint before the Office of the Ombudsman. That's for Udena's buyout of Chevron's 45% stake in the Malampaya gas project. The complaint was lodged by concerned citizens who alleged that Pusi and other officials conspired to give Udena undue advantage in the sale. Pusi has dismissed the complaint as a mere political propaganda. Udena now has a 90% stake in Malampaya after buying Shell's 45% stake earlier this year. The transactions were questioned in the Senate, but Pusi had denied that they were so-called midnight deals.
The Philippines has seen 8 straight weeks of fuel price spikes. Despite this, transport authorities are not keen on granting the request of jeepney groups for a hike in transport fares. Alvin Lachico tells us why.
Gasoline prices are now over 60 pesos per liter, while diesel has reached the 50 peso level in Metro Manila. In the provinces, fuel prices are more expensive in some areas based on photos and videos sent by bayan patrollers. After 8 straight weeks of fuel price spikes, diesel prices are now 8.50 pesos per liter more, while gasoline is over 7 pesos more expensive. Despite the staggering oil prices, government has yet to come up with concrete measures to help the transport sector. Jeepney groups filed a petition to raise the minimum fare by 3 pesos, but the regulator says it is unlikely to be approved.
Ang guidance po ni Secretary, kung pwede hindi magtataas ng pamasahe, kasi on one hand, we understand very much, no, the concern and the basis for the petition Pero kung papayagan po natin yung petition na yan, may matatamaan naman na mas nakakarami.
The Transportation Department will recommend increasing passenger capacity for public transport. Delgra says the House Transportation Committee has called for a hearing Wednesday to discuss ways to help drivers. Delgra adds fuel subsidies can be revived or discounts can be expanded for public utility jeepneys. But the problem is, higher fuel prices in the international market are likely to stay until end of the year.
Hanggang end of this year, yung deficit na 2.91. But OPEC, based dun sa nakaraang meeting nila ng October 4, ang kainalang pwedeng i-release pa lang yung 400,000 barrels per month, na mag-i-even out ang supply and demand by end of this year.
Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi has asked Congress to amend the oil regulation law to enable government to respond when fuel prices continuously spike. Alvin Olchico, ABS-CBN News.